All right, guys. Well, today we're going to make these folded ribbon roses. You like it?
Yeah.
Yes?
Yeah? All right. Well, it's pretty easy to make, so let's all do one at the same time. So why don't you cut off a couple of pieces of tape so you just have them ready?
Small tape?
Yeah, just a couple of small pieces at first and just have them next to you. And what color ribbon are you using?
It's a pretty neat ribbon. It's yellow on the outside and then peach on the inside.
Nice! Alright, well I'm going to use this really nice fuchsia, deep kind of pink color. So the longer the ribbon is, the more petals you're going to have because we're going to go round and round and round like that. So if you have a longer piece of ribbon, you're just going to get a bigger rose. So you can try it out and see what you like. And next time, if you think the rose is too big, you just cut a shorter length.
Okay.
Alright, so first of all, we're going to put our ribbon down. So take one end of it and just put it flat on the table like that. I'm going to move the tape out of the way. And now you're going to get the long part of the ribbon and leave about this much distance from the ends. And then we're going to fold it over to the right hand side and you're going to make kind of like an L shape out of your ribbon. Okay? That's it. So that's perfect, you guys. Now you see where you folded it? Just like origami, you're going to use your finger and you're going to crease that. So push down, make it a really nice fold. That's it. Excellent. Now hold that with your left hand and then you're going to take the rest of the ribbon and you're going to fold it upwards this time. Like that, so that it runs parallel to the rest of your ribbon. That's it. Fold it upwards. And don't put it right next to the other piece of ribbon. Leave a little space between them. Yeah, that's great. Can you see? Like I have a little gap in the middle there. So again, hold it with your left hand and we're going to take the long part of the ribbon and we're going to flip it over to the left side this time. So when you fold it over, you see how there's like a little square gap in the middle there? So
yeah.
If you fold yours a little further up, then you'll leave that space there. And that's what you want to always have, is that little square gap in the center. So now we have kind of like a square shape made out of the ribbon, yeah? And we're going to fold again all the way around. So we're going to repeat the same fold, basically. So bring it down towards you. And you can kind of line it up over the previous fold. So, we're just going to keep going round and round like that, you guys. So, why don't you follow the folds that are underneath? Keep going round, creasing as you go. Pretty simple, right? Very repetitive. So the only thing that gets a little tricky is just holding everything in place when you're starting to get like a big stack of ribbon. You don't want to let go, you have to start all over again.
Do we keep going until it's all gone?
Yeah, actually you're getting pretty close, so you're going to keep folding until you have a very tiny short piece left.
They're short?
Can you fit one more fold, do you think? Yeah. Alright. So you guys, that was pretty simple up until now, right? We were just doing basic folding and creasing. So this part is a little bit more tricky. So I'm going to hold it with my left hand. I'm going to make sure that I'm holding all the parts, all the folds. And then this part is going to become the center of the rose. So what I'm going to do is, you see this this corner right here?
Mm-hmm.
And you know the hole that you guys left in the center?
Mm-hmm.
That's where we're going to stick this end now. So we're going to put it through there. So let me show you on this one first. I'm going to look to the back. I'm going to try and find that corner and pull it through. There it is. So I'm not going to pull it all the way. I'm going to pull it to about here. And then you see in the center, do you see how it's starting to coil up? I'm going to twist that round and round. And then this is the tricky part. I got to let go here. I can't just hold my thumb there because the petals want to start curling up now. So I'm very carefully going to remove my thumb and hold further under. And keep twisting that. And you see how it's starting to form the shape of a rose as the petals twist around? I'm going to keep going like that. Twist, 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 and twist. And see, all those folds became petals now. So what do I have now? I have a whole swirl of petals. I have the beginning part of the ribbon, and I have this middle part that I've twisted round and round. Now what I have to do is put this part together with that part, and I just squish them together, really, like that. Squish them together, and then twist them round one another. And I'm just going to secure that with a piece of tape, and then you can make the stem look nicer later on. That's basic thing you have to do. Then you can rearrange the petals. That's looking great. Just put a piece of tape really high up to hold those two pieces together. So now that we've made the rose, we can grab some more tape. And we want to cut a long piece.
How long?
There you go. Something like that. That's good. So we're going to use the tape now to make our stem. And basically what we're going to do is, again, twist these pieces of ribbon up. And then what do you think we're going to do?
Wrap it around.
Exactly. So you can start at the bottom or the top, and you just want to wrap that tape all the way around. And it's up to you how much tape you want to put on it. You want to make a really thick stem, then you're just going to keep adding tape. So what did you make with your, with one of these roses?
A pin that sticks to the flower so you can put it on your shirt.
And here I have a pen for writing.
So you just taped all the way down the pen?
Yep, and it's green to match the stem. And we have a milk carton so that you can put flowers in it just for decorations at your home, your classrooms, or just in events like weddings.
Mm-hmm. Or at a job.
At your job or your desk.
I hope you guys enjoyed making ribbon roses with us today. And why don't you write in and tell us what you made? Did you do anything extra with your rose? Show us pictures.
Keep calm and make on!